Okay. Welcome to the shirt drafting class. In this class, we are going to be needing our pattern paper. You can see we have our pattern paper. And we have our ruler, French curve, have our pen. Then our tape, then finally our scissors. With this, we are good to go. Measurements, we are going to measure neck. We are going to have shoulder. We are going to have arm sleeve. Then sleeve length. They will have chest. Then we have length. So in this case, our neck is going to be 17, our shoulder is going to be 18, around sleeve is going to be 14, our sleeve length is going to be 9 and 23.5. Then our chest is going to be 40. Then our length is going to be 30. These are the measurements you need for shirts. So, let's... First of all, take your length. Now, if this place is not equal, this is a pattern drafting paper. The four edges are equal. In case you are doing this in a material, draw a straight line from here, then trim it up to make sure that it is straight. But in this case now, I'm not going to rule any line. I already have my length. So first of all, I'm going to mark out 1/2 inch. Still going to mark out 1/2 inch here. So I'll roll it. And my length is going to start from here. Measure 30 inches. I'm going to add 1/2 inch for the folding. So I'll mark it. reduces my length. So I'm going to mark 2 inches here. 2 inches here. I'll mark 2 inches actually here. I'll still mark at the downside. So I'm going to connect the line. This is my button. This is for the button. This is for the button. I'm going to fold it. Now I'm going to mark 1/2 inch. This 1/2 inch is for button sitting. The button sitting and the overlapping. Alright, now I'm going to take my measurement from here, from this line, this is where I'm going to take, not here, this is where I'm going to take all my measurements down. So our chest is 40, we divide 40 into 4, we divide 40 into 4. Then add the allowance. 40 divided by 4 is 10. Now I'm going to add 1.5 inch allowance, 10. 1.5 inch allowance. This 1.5 inch allowance, I just want to add it so that I will be able to get the hip side. So I'm adding it because the hip side, I'm going to add 1/2 inch. Normally the joining, the allowance will be 1/2 inch. So I'm going to add 1.5 inch to measure it. So from here, you can decide to add 2 inches just for you to be on the safer side. So here too, 11.5. So I'm going to connect this line. So like this now, this is the front part of it. So I'm going to cut it off. This is the front panel. This is the front panel. This is the front panel. I'm going to bring this is the one I will use for the back panel. So what I did here, this is the 11.5. 11.5 is what I'm going to measure for the back. Then the length we have. Length we have is 31. 31 for this one. So I'm going to measure out 11.5. So we're going to measure 11.5 here. Measure 11.5 here. So I'm going to connect this line. So we have 31 at the front. We have 31 at the front. I mark 31. I mark 31 here. So I'm going to add extra 3 inches allowance. Some persons may add 3.5, some person will add 2.5, depending on the shoulder of the person. How you want it to slant, how you want it to fall, because the back is always longer than the front. So I'm going to add extra 3 inches allowance to this. So I'll roll this line. I'll roll this one. Okay, remember 11.5.
All right, I'm cutting it out. All right, do wait to subscribe to this channel, Classic Sewing Workshop, and turn on your notification bell so that whenever we drop an amazing video like this, you will see, you get the notification. So this video is going to have a part 2. So see you in the part 2 of this video.